friends. This is Seabass here out Bonneville Dam fishing for shad. Ah! Oh my God, super excited. We have a whole bunch of the Slayer Squad members here fishing with us. This is our first kind of congregated Slayer Squad trip out here for shad. It's gonna be awesome. Everyone's all rigged up. We're all ready to go. Right here, we have my school friend Brody.
Hello.
We have my little brother Xavier right here. Also my school friend Eli. Back here we have Phillip. How's it going?
Hello.
Where's Casey? What happened to Casey? Oh, there he is. Right there's Casey. We have Nick's dad right there, and then there's Nick. We have Sean, my dad, Jack. That's it. All right. Oh yeah, and then also, we have Ryan Moore and Patrick Doyle fishing down there. They decided to speed ahead of us and get a head start. So they're down there. They're going to come back and join us later. But let's go catch some shad, everyone. Woo! Woo!
That's not a shad. That's not a shad.
Easy, okay?
Yeah.
Look at the bit.
That's a sturgeon or a king, dude.
Yeah.
Definitely not a
bass.
Oh, that'd be sturgeon. Get control of it, right?
Get control of it.
Dude.
Go with it. Go with it.
No. Stay. Get control of it.
Get control of it. Turn it.
No, dude.
It's
not fighting like a king.
That was salmon that take off.
Yeah. Okay, baby.
It's a slow, steady throbs. Could be a big catfish, too.
Ooh.
Bonus hole.
Okay, what are we putting bets on?
There you go.
Yeah, sturgeon.
Could be.
Oh.
I'm thinking sturgeon or big catfish.
Yeah, you might have snagged him in the back. He's trying to run from you.
He's right here. Control him, man. Go. Keep pump it.
Pump.
There you go.
There you go.
Oh. Keep control.
It's a sturgeon.
Yeah, you might want to control that thing.
Careful, there's a hook right there.
Ten.
You're welcome.
Light drag, not very much line. We're gonna see what happens. He's not that far out, but I think I think it's a sturgeon, man. Ooh, I'm so excited if it's a sturgeon. That's a dream fish.
Don't put your hand on the bell, don't.
Why do you line?
No shit. I don't want to horse him too much.
The lima glass rod is going to break first before you line.
Yeah, I know. If I break this fish off, there's going to be some foul language, I can tell you that.
Okay. Really, he's not a fish. He's just
you see the third?
He's boiled.
It just boiled.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, dude.
Somebody's line.
Cut that line. Get that line off there. Get that line off.
The hook.
Get the line off.
Reel in fast, okay? Go. Reel fast. Up, up.
Gotta keep that rod up.
Yeah. We're 6 minutes in it.
6 minutes in on the fight.
He's right here.
He's right here. A sturgeon.
Holy shit!
It's a big ass sturgeon, dude.
That's sturgeon. Sturgeon.
Oh, oh shit, dude! Woo! We all saw that!
Yeah.
You scared a heck of a lot of you ran from you.
Yes!
Did I tell you this week's a blue moon thing?
Oh.
Not for you.
Dude, that thing
get
that.
Well, he's gonna run.
He's gonna wear himself out.
Super sketchy, man.
Right?
30 pound sturgeon on a steelhead rod, dude. What?
Why do you
keep moving?
There.
I don't know.
I'm happy,
man. I am so, so stoked right now about this sturgeon.
You think you broke your waterproof boots on?
Yeah.
Oh, it's right there. Shit.
Oh, dude. Oh, it's a big sturgeon, man. He's hooked in the mouth.
Well, he's definitely not in the ass.
Mouth, man.
You flosser.
Snagger.
Having dreams, jumping on a trampoline, flipping in the air. I never land, just float there.
Please.
Yeah, watch out for the guy's fish.
Let's go get taken out by
Bring him slow, right?
Slow.
Keep your rod up, walk back. Keep your rod up, buddy.
Walk back.
Remember, keep him in the water. You have to keep him in the water.
There he goes, fish.
Watch out for the tail. Oh, shit. There he goes, man.
Oh, he's tired. Oh, he's getting tired.
Get that dart off. Get that dart off. Oh. Yep, we're good.
Ryan, take it easy, dude. Don't.
Thank you. Oh, that was down in the rocks.
Oh no.
Keep your rod up. Rod up. Yeah.
Oh my god.
Hey, get it.
You have to
control it.
That bend though.
We're
going down.
Almost out of land. Hey, he's going to get in front of them. What's the time on there?
No, you're 13 minutes in it, buddy.
Okay. He's right there.
Uh-huh. Right now walk there. Back a little bit. Walk back a little bit. Keep him in the water. If you pull his head up, he's gonna sea bass. Grab him by the tail.
Get that thing.
Yeah.
Keep going back.
Don't go.
Grab him by the body.
Trying to go for the mouth.
Damn it! I almost
had him.
That's not gonna happen.
They're fine. They're good. Just play your game and, you know, let them do what they do. It's okay, Ryan. It's only a fish. There's nothing to... Eat.
He's gonna come in.
Mouth him, grab him by the mouth. He'll be coming in like that.
Sea bass is gonna come in.
Oh!
Yeah.
don't try to lift your rod when you get close. Just kind of pull him back.
Yeah.
So you know he's still in the water.
I'm not
going to
start walking back
in a second.
Where are
you going? You got the line? Ready. If he runs, let him go. Let him go.
He's coming.
Let me get back down there.
No. Stay there. He's coming.
Can I say Sturgeon will eat anything? He'll eat anything.
He's coming.
You gotta come back down.
Jack, you need to stay still, buddy. Okay? You're gonna get hurt, believe me. Okay, don't worry about it.
Grab that tail.
No,
I got him.
Hold on.
Two hands, both hands, buddy. Pull him back a little bit.
Here, grab the rod. Somebody grab this.
Scissors.
He's good.
Give him a kiss, Dale.
I flipped him upside down. He should be stable.
Got it?
Yeah. Scissors, you guys. Scissors.
Fire.
Anybody got scissors?
Watch out for his.
Watch out for his back. I see it. Alright, you guys ready?
Hold on, look. Cut the line first.
Grab by the gill plate.
Just cut the line.
Alright. Hold on. No, keep him in the water. Go ahead.
Good?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm releasing him.
Nice catch, buddy. Nice catch.
He's gonna take off a little slow.
Good job,
man.
Yeah!
Heck yeah! Fishy friends, here's an update. We have successfully caught shad, but we came through a couple of fish that aren't typically on our list for shad fishing. First of all, this guy right here, Ryan, caught like a 45-pound sturgeon in the mouth, not snagged, and landed it. He landed it. We grabbed it by the tail, took a picture, and we released it. Okay, and then after that, Ryan caught like two more shad. He was getting all pumped up. And then next thing you know, Jack hooks into a sturgeon. That thing jumps. He got that on camera. Then it finally came off. Yeah, he got it on camera. And then we catch a couple more shad. I'll show you guys the shad here in a second. And then I'm reeling my line in, and then I hook a sturgeon. Anyways.
What the heck?
Shad in our catch cooler. Sorry about that. We got four so far. And then I think Sean has three down there. We got Sean?
Yep.
Sean's on a fish. Dang it.
I don't even know. What color is that?
Came off.
Invisible.
Two.
Yeah, Jack, there's a lot of sturgeons sitting out there right now.
Float rock. I'm taking my float off.
Welcome to shad fishing, guys.
Oh, come on, this is not the salt water.
To show you the setup that we're using today, we have, I'm just experimenting new methods and ways on how to fish for shad. Like, I was trying a couple of Pac-Man weights that led up to about 3/4 ounce, 1/2 ounce, and that kind of worked, but it hasn't caught me any shad yet, so I can't really say that it did work. Otherwise, our main technique that we're using today is we have our 1/2 ounce slip sinker, then we have our swivel, and then about 3 feet of line to our shad dart. We're using chartreuse. Chartreuse and red is usually the hot colors for shad here. And that's what Ryan caught all of the shad and sturgeon with, is with a red head and then rest of chartreuse body with, I think, 1/2 ounce or 3/4 ounce weight. And basically all you're doing is, you know, probably casting it out 20 feet in front of you, 30 feet in front of you, and right when it hits the water, bam, you flip your bail, and then you slowly retrieve in. And basically just keep that slow, steady retrieve. And if you feel anything, set the hook. It might be a rock, it might be a shad, you never know. And that's why you bring a whole bunch of shad darts, because... Or you never know if you're gonna catch a sturgeon or not. All right, guys, let's go get to some more fishing here and hopefully catch some more shad.
Good job, buddy.
Man, you are something else.
Yeah.
Man, what are you tie it a little bit better.
I tied it perfectly fine.
How the hell flew off?
Okay. So this is our shad so far. There's some pretty big ones in there. Not gonna lie. That guy's a pretty big one. Probably like 2 or 3 pounders. Some pretty small ones in there too. They're kind of varied. Patrick currently has one on right now. Only if he can land it this time.
Oh,
there is fish being, oh, there's fish being caught everywhere. Okay. Okie dokies. Guys, let's try to catch some more shad. Eli, catch a shad.
Bank flip? Or are you gonna lose it?
Bank flip it right to me. Jack, duck!
Come on back.
Duck!
1, 2, 3! Oh.
That one up too, huh?
Yep.
Sure did. And
I'll let you know the color of them.
Oh, bash.
Deep throw down.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to get my Leatherman. It's down in there pretty good.
Why is that dunk is cut away?
that way, they don't get tangled.
Down one.
Was that a time for a water break?
Yeah.
I have a fish on.
He just real.
He should have swallowed the hook. I let him stay out there.
Okay. Okay. I can do this. That's how we do it down here at the Bondi. Let's see the fish.
Drop your rod for a minute.
Go.
Up, reel down, buddy. Up, reel down.
Up, reel down.
There you go.
Isn't that fun?
Yeah.
Fight?
Yeah. Oh! But I haven't seen anything over there. It's like the perfect spot over here, huh?
Yeah, no, come over here, dude.
Okay.
I was trying to. If Brody was still here, he would have caught that fish.
Yeah.
Eli, here.
Eli, go.
All right.
Walk this way.
Come down.
Hey, that felt good.
That's a big one, dude.
Nice job.
That's a chunky one.
Handline that.
Nope. That's how we do it. Exactly. Absolutely choked the dart.
I don't know why you're laughing, dude. I got your butt cracking video, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Dang it.
Oh, he's flossing. Flossing.
What? Chicken?
Oh, I might have to get caught, dude.
Huh? I lost count how many I got, but I figure out a pattern.
Go ahead, see.
Okay. Chartreuse, dark top. Half ounce weight, 5-4 foot leader. Slow, close, and deep.
Sucker.
Thank you. How much you weigh, Pat? It didn't work? It's too heavy?
It don't work. I think it counts though.
Yes, it can. The world speaks to those who listen. Its voice travels over the tallest peaks and across the widest rivers. Whispering legend of the traveling man and his strength through thick and thin. It tells the story of his past, and how none of it matters. How he climbs the world. Because every step into the unknown is a triumph over adversity. Every breath, a defiance of death. And at the edge, he shares his journey with the world. And it listens. It's your turn. Be legendary.
In this video about the Patrick catching shad.
I have a name, it's called Dr. Shad.
And I'm the Sturgeon General.
Something.
And we got a screamer in the back.
Sorry about little kids screaming.
Secret.
Oh. You should.
Fantastic.
Can you make some for the Slayer Squad? Thank you, dude. I almost took out my face.
It took like 3 hours. I got a 45 pound sturgeon this morning and then I went like 3 hours without a bite.
Hey, you
want to
leave some fish for everybody
else? Yeah, right.
Here, I got it.
Awesome job.
Thank you.
at home.
Fish my secret.
You gotta let it get to the bottom. A little super, super slow. Just got one on.
Slow motion with it.
Yeah, slow motion. Slow motion. Whatever speed you're doing, slow-mo it.
And you're ready. Is that how you catch the shad?
Yeah. Exactly.
We have less than an hour left here at Bonneville Dam before we have to head home, and finally the shad are picking up. We have caught shad more. We have caught more shad in the last hour than we have all day. So we're trying to get as much shad right there. Jack, show me your fish.
Got this one.
Yeah. So we're trying to get as many fish as we can before we head out. Then we'll distribute it so everyone has some crab, good crab bait. I think Nick said he's gonna smoke some, right?
Oh!
Everyone's hooking them now. Like, everyone is hooking them, like, home. From down there, all the way over here, Patrick, Ryan, Sean, Jack, Nick, Eli, Brody, all the way down there, and then all the way down there as well, are people catching shad. Yes, catching shad. These are all of our shad so far. This bag is completely full pretty much, and this is another bag, almost full. So we're doing pretty good.
There you go. Closer, honey. Get closer. Closer.
I can be in a picture if you want to be.
Oh, no, I don't want to be in a picture. I'm never in a picture. All right.
How many?
I don't know.
Don't know.
We had about like 20, 30.
We didn't even make a dent.
No, not at all. It didn't start picking up until later on in the day, yeah.
Brian.
Hey, does it look like a catfish bait?
30 exactly in this room.
Oh, yeah, dude.
No. Like I said, only chat we catch back home is like this big.
Snake River, found catfish.
Yep.
That can be our next trip.
Was that catfish?
30, 29 and out.
Yeah. Come on, you guys, stand behind it.
Can you send some over?
Yeah. Yeah.
30,
I'll send it to Nick. Or you want me to send it to you?
Okay.
Yeah,
because
how long haven't you gone
catfishing?
71.
My guess was 70. We've been over 30 years.
Okay, so we are back home. We are at Sportco and FIFE right now. This is our final meetup spot. Jack's dad is right there. His truck is right there. They're inside checking out a couple stuff. We just got back from inside there checking out a couple stuff as well. So I don't know. They're still wandering around inside. They close in like 5 minutes, so they got to get out soon. But otherwise, it was an awesome trip. I know Eli... Where's Brody? Oh, there's Brody. Okay. I know Eli and Brody had an awesome time. First time shad fishing. You guys had fun?
Yep.
Heck yeah. Patrick, you had fun?
One. Yes, I did.
Yes, you did. Sean, you had fun?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. If Jack was here, I can get his opinion on it. But a little recap of the day. We got there around 9 o'clock. Ryan decided to speed down there with Patrick and his girlfriend, and Ryan's girlfriend, and... They basically got there like 30 minutes before us, and we left at the same time. So they got there early. They kind of scoped it out a little bit for us. And then along the way, I called Phillip Brewer, and he was riding along with one of his friends, Casey. And we met up with him. Had some little troubles in the middle for like kind of meeting up a little bit. Otherwise, we made everything. We made it all the way down to Bonneville Dam safely. A whole bunch of people. I'd say over probably maybe 2,000 people on both Washington and Oregon side shad fishing. So there's a lot of people. for the first 3 to 4 hours, I'd say it was pretty slow for the most part. I'd say I think we only got like 20 fish or so between all of us, but some bonus catches that were absolutely amazing was the sturgeon that Ryan caught. That was about a 45-pound sturgeon caught on his little steelhead rod. I still can't believe you landed that fish on 10-pound line and a little tiny 32nd ounce shad dart. I don't know. He fought it for like 20 minutes or so. Yeah, that the thing is like that big. And then Jack hooked into a sturgeon. It ran off for him for like 5 seconds and then jumped off into the air. And then he finally lost it. And then I hooked into a sturgeon as well. At least I believe so. I didn't see it. Because like I like hooked it near the shore and then it ran off and went zzz, 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 and then just like ran off completely. And then finally came off. I got all my gear back though. You guys getting gear?
Yeah.
Okay. But otherwise, after that, I think after there's like a sturgeon epidemic. So the sturgeon were there and then the shad weren't. So there was no shad for us to catch besides just the sturgeon there. So the sturgeon were scaring away all the shad, and then basically there's no fish for us to catch. And after that, after all the sturgeon moved, it was open season. We probably got 50 to 60 fish after that in about an hour before we had to leave. It was literally like every other cast were getting a fish. Eli got to fight some fish. Even though he was having some troubles with hooking them and just kind of feeling them, but it's really hard to get used to. So he got to feel some nice fighting shad. They fight almost like pink salmon, which is absolutely amazing. So we're going to be using all the shad for crab bait. Everyone had fun. Where's Jack Rooney? Let me go say bye to Jack. Ryan and Nick had to leave somewhere because they're driving. But Jack, come here.
See ya.
You had fun?
Today. Yep.
Yes. Let's plan future trips, okay?
Coming out next year.
Yes. Come out next year shad fishing?
Yep.
All right. I'll see you later.
Squid season's upon us.
Yes.
Crabbing's first.
Crabbing's first.
See you later.
Alrighty guys, so that's going to be on the road for us here. Thank you all for joining the Slayer Squad shad fishing trip to Bonneville Dam. We had an absolute amazing time here. See you guys later. Bye. So long from Sportco and FIFE. Bye-bye! Woo!